our DBF race to play race at Martinsville. It's 175 laps. This is David Nannon alongside with Daniel Blanco and cameraman Sydney Thomas.
Luis Almeida and Marcio Cayetano have started on the front row today. So we're going to have a 2-minute warm-up session here. They're going to go run some laps, practice pitting, and then we should start the race. I believe we have 3 Canadians in the field today, Len Venn, Jim Barisaw, and Ron Coles.
You are actually correct.
So 3 out of the 9 racers.
We're in warm-up right now, just everybody getting their last-minute changes ready for the race today, and should be a good one.
Oh, someone in the wall down there. One. Marcio Cayetano. Practicing pitting. How Len Venn, really good at Martinsville, very little amounts of stock car series background, and looking like a pretty smooth line he has right now on Martinsville.
Yeah, he comes from the road course side of things.
Yep, more towards the open wheel, yeah.
Yeah, open wheel. Like, he normally runs our, the race play. Like, does he run, like, more the
Formula
BMWs?
Yeah, Formula BMW.
Yep, Ronnie Martin is normally a...
That concludes warm-up, and it's Eric Harlan winning.
Yep, Eric Harlan, like, this season and late last season, he's shown us a lot of improvement.
Yeah, he's starting to heat up with DBF Motorsports.
Mm-hmm.
Who's DBF in here? Eric Harlan. Oh, Ellery Souza just hit the top spot in last second.
Yep.
So, Eric Harlan, Ronnie Martin, Ron Coles, those are all DBF, and we're about to go green.
Start your engine!
Alright, so I'm going to walk you guys through the starting lineup here. On the pole right now, Luis Almeida. He also won practice, so very cool fast car for him. Marcio Cayetano, I believe his teammates alongside of him in row number two, in second spot on row number one. Then Ron Coles, Canadian, the highest of the DBF guys. Room on our arms, the rocket ball line, didn't get the job done this time, just goes to the starts in fourth position. Jim Barisaw from the DBF now. Darts. Him, Eric Harlan, another DBF driver.
Talking about Scott Stenger, though, he's really gotten on the move lately. Like, I've looked at some of the past results.
Did he even win this season?
I don't know if he's got a win or not, but I think
he's... Pace car's out, right? It's a lot to green.
But yeah.
Pace race cars out.
Green flag, green flag.
And we are green up until.
It's looking like side by side. You want to go through turn one, two.
Car pretty clean.
Side by side back. Who's gonna end up getting clear? Seems like the first three rows are still side by side.
And Luis clears them.
Yep, Luis will get lead the first lap.
Basically, I don't believe there's any bonus points for leading a lap. So leading a lap here is pretty much for stats, not much for.
Yep.
It's not going to get you anything in the stand.
Which, at this track right here, getting out front is the best place to be.
Oh yeah, you don't want to be in the sandwich.
Yeah.
You don't want to get on ground.
Yeah, so, like, I guess getting out front of this place would be a bonus.
Yeah.
If we have a smoker of Len Venn in the back, so.
Len Venn, that's not good, huh?
What? On the street.
Oh yeah, he smoked big time. Wonder if he still has his qualifying set in. Yeah, he's pulling over. Looks like
Luis
is here for Len Venn. He might still have. Yeah, he's gonna enter the pits now. Still smoking. Maybe probably left his Q set up in, or maybe his tape just did too high. He will pit on about 100. Not what? 30 for qualifying.
Yeah, it is. 30. I guess 30. Luis Almeida in the lead right now. He's pulling away from Marcio a little bit. Ron Coles is actually catching Marcio.
Yeah, Ron Coles having a good race in third.
Yeah.
Good to see him do that.
Yeah, it's talking about Ron Coles, like, it's been a while since he's actually been here. I've heard that he does more IndyCar racing now.
Oh yeah, he does a lot of IndyCar racing, like that.
Yeah.
And a bit of road course racing, right now.
Yeah, he like, I don't remember who he races with, but yeah, he does a lot of that, and I guess, like, all last year, he hadn't even finished, like, off seeing FX.
Also, another thing about Ron, a couple of seasons ago, he ended, before he was a long break, he ended on a very long DNF streak. He really wasn't doing good, he wasn't finishing up.
Yeah.
So to see him back up front, at least 30, good.
Yeah, I remember back when I raced a little bit, there'd be, like, any race that he'd be in, like, he'd end up, like, upside down, or...
Yeah, wrecking, or getting caught up in someone else's mess.
Just putting in before him.
Yeah. And a lot of computer troubles, also.
Yeah.
The long break. Haven't raced this long at all, so it's much the same, actually. Nothing new.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go back to the field. We have one more orange here. The massively good qualifier. Surprised he did not get the pole today, especially at a track like Martinsville. You'd think he would have a sexy setup show off here. More like a 17 second lap, but qualified fourth and is maintaining that spot. I don't know how down the road.
Yeah, Jim Beresoff is currently running in fifth place.
Canadian.
Yes, Canadian. He's one of those drivers that like on the
he's
bigger
really
track.
Consistent.
Yeah, he's very consistent. It seems like more on the bigger tracks like California, Michigan. He gets up there and runs for the lead a lot. But just like more just the smaller, more like 1 mile tracks. Mid-packer. I mean, he waits until the very end.
Yeah, he does, and
he
waits until the very end. It's a very good strategy. Wish I could do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like Jim. Very, very consistent driver. He won a championship last season in the truck series?
I think it was the Nationwide, I thought.
Yeah, I was thinking that too, actually. He had the truck series championship, I believe.
Yeah.
But he also has a couple of other ones, which is surprising, because if you look at his stats, he doesn't have a lot of wins, but he does have a lot of podiums, and he just finishes up there consistently every race. He will finish good.
Yeah.
Whether he wrecks, and he doesn't give up, this kid, so... I see this kid, he's like,
yeah.
Oh, battle for the lead, and Marcio gets by him. Late on that.
Yeah, going through turn three, he just got low on Luis. Like, I know they're teammates.
Catching up to a lead car.
Are they still teammates?
I believe so. I am pretty sure they are
teammates. I think last race, I don't know if Marston or not, but he wasn't on their team anymore. But, I mean, if they are still teammates, then maybe it's just a team strategy, you know?
Yeah, maybe.
Or something.
But there's no bonus points, remember, so maybe it's just to have some.
Well, oops. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know if that is bonus points this season. I don't think so. Catching up to a lap on your left, man.
Yeah, speaking of Lindman, if he can stay out in front of him and get a quick caution, he'll get the rest of this lap back and a walkie dog. So hopefully he can get himself a little caution.
Yep. Martinsville, you never know. It's just that he is in the caution.
Back going to the field, Eric Harland. He had a good little happy hour session there. He might be just conserving his tires for a long run. I mean,
he was sixth in practice and qualified eighth, so a little bit further back.
Yeah,
expecting more out of him.
Yeah, maybe he changed something in his happy hour setup and he got himself second, didn't he?
He was second in Ellery's season.
Yeah, so maybe he's just saving something. Ellery's right behind him, so.
It's weird to see Ellery Sousa at a track like this, not doing as good as the leader, but he is on the same.
Yes, he is.
Just making sure.
Talk about that team. Is Roma Arns on that team?
Yeah, Roma Arns is definitely on that team.
Okay.
Runner,
but so, yeah, there's four of them.
Potentially. Oh, and lap car, yeah. Left end, going another lap down. Left bend. It looks like a very nice, clean line. I have so much respect for this guy. Really, really cool guy. Nice personality. Really clean racer. He just wants to go out there and have fun. He's not really looking for any competition.
Yeah. And talk about, like, Lin Van, and hopefully he sticks around the VHR and racing like this and stuff. Next season, DBF's going to be switching over to Sydney Thomas, our cameraman's series, iPro Race Auto Sport, Association. So, good
that's
seeing
that's going to be great to see. I didn't know that. That's a great tip. Oh, battle for the lead possibly here in the race's course. After some laps left, but it seems to have backed off. So, I guess, under the arc.
But yeah, so Tuesday night's going to be Sydney. When is Tuesday night going to be?
Tuesday nights we're going to have the Chemical Truck Series. Standard time, 9:15, starts qualifying. And on Saturday we will have the Cup Series. It's going to be an early East Coast morning, 11:15 starts the qualifying.
Okay, that's good information to know. So the BHR trucks and cups are going to be sticking around.
Yeah, that's very good to see Sydney Thomas get back after a long vacation, apparently.
Yeah.
And he was, I missed this guy. Man, I really missed him. He was gone for like 4 months. No, I've grown up. Now he's back. He's going to be starting his own stock car leaders. And we should hear his podcast most of those interviews. Just keeping an eye on Ronnie Martin here. I'm surprised on how actually slow he is. They're both Ronnie and the other one. What's his name?
Stinger.
No, Ronnie Martin and Stinger.
What'd you say?
What's the other Martin? I forgot.
Oh, wow. Joseph? Hey. How do you not know Joseph?
I haven't been in a VHR for a while. But anyway, Ronnie, very good. And hired back way back in the back here, actually. So, the last car.
Yeah. Yes, he would be. But yeah, talking about Ronnie, like, I think most of, like, he's really good on, like, speedway type tracks. But short tracks, I don't think he's ever really gotten, like, the groove in them. So.
Yeah, that's true. I saw him at Richmond one time. He wasn't very good. Well, hopefully he keeps it in there today. Battle for third, creeping up here. Ron Coles and Omar Arms. Really cool to see Ron up here. I like that.
Canadian.
And Scott Stinger is, I think, first car one lap down, yes.
About 28 of 125.
Yeah. So we're clicking off laps pretty quick here.
Yep, no caution so far.
good
run. There might be some, but thank you, but on his battle there on my arms. Very aggressive driver here.
Everywhere.
He's known for being an aggressive driver, so let's see what he does at Martinsville. Get this to play.
And
caution. Left vent turned around and turn number two and backed it up from the wall.
Get caught up there, buddy.
It looks like he's don't look like he has too much damage.
Oh, he looped it. Whoa, in front of the leaders. He panicked. But also some pretty extensive right side damage from the left ones. And the left wheel.
It'll be fixed. I mean, being at a short track, it ain't gonna hurt him that bad, so.
Yeah, a hard time getting it going here. Gotta be careful.
Yeah, he's back going now, so hopefully he can just get back going and finish out the race. Three laps down, if you get three laps, you'll be back.
Alright, this is lap 30, and I promised my good friend from Montreal to give him a bit of a shout out today. He is watching at home right now. His name is, we call him eBay. And he is watching from home. I said in the lap 30, I'll give him a bit of a shout out, so. Heads up for him, he's watching today's first broadcast in our series, so good friend of mine and David's.
Yes.
Very, very cool kid.
The pitting.
Yep,
pit stops.
Can Luis get out in front of Marcio?
I love pit stops in the HR, I just love that. Fun.
Going 30 miles
big,
per hour.
Big gap, pit big gap between the two up front and then third and fourth, so or maybe some strategy, maybe some two tires. Who knows?
Who knows?
And Marcio got in way before Luis did. He took a while to get into his pit box. Let's see.
It's not looking like there's any two tires right now. Oh,
that's gonna be Marcio getting out just in front of Luis, Ron Coles, Omar Arndt, Jim Barrasso.
And looks like about everybody just kind of came out where they came in.
Yep.
So.
Eric Harlan, L.A. Souza, Lendman, good job getting the damage fixed. Scott Bender, long pit stop on pit row. Looks like he's going to go a lap down. Or another one, actually. Ronnie Martin exits the pits. There we go. Oh, can he beat the pace car out? He needs to beat the pace car. Oh. Did he do it?
Yeah, he did.
Wow, that was cool.
Inches.
That was nice.
Maybe just a foot. He barely beat that pace car.
Oh wow!
And that, like, he ends up getting the lucky dog this time. So
yeah, he's still on the lead.
He almost would have ended up.
Yeah, he's on the lead lap now. Oh, hold on, he's going. I did not beat the pace car. Nice. Again, we'll see if he has. Are you just waiting confirmation?
It'll be one to go this time, by.
I hope. Yep, it looks like he's
speeding. Yeah, it
speeded,
looks like he's
so
got it.
He's picking up speed, so.
Good for him. That was cool. Alright, so same field as before. Hope eBay's enjoying the racing.
Yes.
Big old
fan.
Oh,
I believe eBay is.
Unfortunately, a Jimmy Johnson fan. As he's probably smirking right now, laughing about that.
Shit.
Johnson.
Alright, we're about to go back to green.
I'll go back to
Marcio Caetano gonna be leading, Luis Almeida second, Ron Coles third, Roman Arns fourth, and Jim Barrasson.
Green.
And we're green. Let's see if they all survive for him.
Looks like everybody's giving each other room.
Ron. Why?
Everybody's giving each other room. Spread up. Run set high.
Oh, run high.
Scott Stinger's in the pits for. I don't know why it would be in the pits.
He had a flashlight. Oh, he had a stop and go. Not sure what that's about. He had a stop and go. Possibly going to be for speeding. I didn't see it before when he exited the pits. Maybe it was something to do. Maybe it was a lucky dog, actually. Lucky dog usually gets black flag, so he's still on the VHR bridge. That's something I don't miss.
Yeah.
Oh, he went out, but he did not stop. He still hasn't. He has to go in again. He just did a drive. That's going to really.
No. I think all it was a drive.
No, It still has the symbol there for us.
Oh, he does? Alright.
Yeah. Did not stop to go before. He just did a drive through, so that's sucks for Eric.
Yeah.
Got a battle here for third and fourth.
Yep.
Ron and Romar.
Ron and Romar, yeah. And there's Jim back there. All by himself, he's keeping it clean. Eric Harley. I guess that's even before me. I really hope he is saving it for the end. Eric, I like to see him do good. Hello, Yasuda. Ronnie Martin, really cool guy. Both of them are really nice people. And there's Scott Stender. And he will he stop now? No, he drove by his pit box again. I don't know if he knows that he actually just stopped and go penalty. And not a drive through, so he better get it done quick or it might black flag him.
Looks like he's going to this time.
No, he's not.
Yes, he is.
Last second decision.
Yeah. Should I stay out or nope? I'm gonna go in.
He's on lap 37. He's got four laps down now. He's on lap 41. He's gonna go more. Maybe two more here. So this is definitely a bummer for him. But get like 94 cautions. And I stopped in your dead box. There you go. Alright, so he finally stops.
Alright, back to the lead. It seems like Marcio is pulling away from Luis a bit, so just getting away, get himself some clean air.
Yeah. Embarrassed off hanging with Romar here.
Romar's hanging with Ron too. I think he might want to come a little feel like they're trying to make a move here shortly or not. He's closing in just a little bit, by a little bit.
Len Van still back in the heat up car, still there at Martin, so that's a pretty cool spot. How many races has he done in the stock car? Not many.
Who are you talking about?
Len Van.
Len Van? I'd say
under five.
Yeah.
And for you to have Martin still in your top five races in the stock car, it's cool.
We should run a down.
Oh yeah, go on the hood view.
Just go 120 down in these tight corners.
Oh yeah, it's very hard to see, especially on VHR, how the track's always very slick and really hard under braking, not to lock them up. Be consistent is the key. Not to overheat your brakes or spin your tires. You go into the corner a little bit, like 1 second later, you're in the wall. You brake 1 second earlier, you lose 2 seconds on the track. So, consistency is very important. Ron, he's so skeptical right there. So much closing in. That's gonna allow Jim to close in as well. So, Romar Arns is effectively surrounded by DBF. He has one in front of him and two behind him, so he has four to go.
Yeah.
They could all just gangbang right now, but I don't know. I don't think they can. Nothing much going on for the lead here, guys. You're not missing much on top. It's a good battle right here for third, fourth, fifth.
Yeah, third, fourth, fifth. Like,
the draft is pretty hard. We're on qualified third, so not many people have actually moved or advanced in their qualified positions. We almost started at 4. There, so. So they're actually the exact same. Many people have been to a swap are Cayetano and Almeida. And then probably possibly something like that. We have two people who did not qualify. Elie Souza and Ronnie Martin, maybe another one. But Elie Souza and Ronnie Martin both did not qualify. I just noticed some heavy damage on the right side of the wrong both tires. You can get that tested. Right in front of the number behind the right rear tire, right front tire.
Yeah, I see that too.
Very bad. I'm not sure what he hit to get that.
Maybe
a car on pit road or something.
Maybe.
I didn't catch that.
Yeah, maybe if something was like coming in, they might have like hit a glances out of his car when they were trying to turn in or something.
They had pretty bad accident.
It's not surprising. It's not looking like it's affecting him too much. He's still running in third place.
Yeah, he's running third, running good lap time so far. The fastest lap goes from Marcel Cayetano at 19.8 lap second.
That's really
wild.
Fast.
Yeah, that's fast. Yeah. For race. Guys are all holding their own, but I don't know where that heavy damage came from the mouse. I've never heard any impact. It could have been when we were following Len, though.
Back to Marcio stressed it out to the 2 second lead.
Wow, 2 seconds, good work.
Yeah, talking about like the size of this track, like you might not think 2 seconds is really that big, but like at a track like this, two seconds is huge.
2 seconds here, as you can see, as we can put the camera right here on the gap between Cayetano and Almeida, it's pretty big. As you can see, it's almost a full turn.
Yeah.
So, seconds at a track like, say, Talladega, which is 2 seconds there, you're pretty cool. Let's say, what track? California? 2 seconds to California.
Yeah. Dang.
It's more gainable than the track.
Yeah.
It's not as heavy duty. I mean, here, he looks close, but not really.
Which, you talk about a place like Talladega, like 2 seconds, you can find like 30 cars. I mean,
You can find like a whole field within 2 seconds of each other. It's a good point right there.
Which, talking about Talladega, that one's coming up here in just a few weeks, I'm pretty positive.
Yeah. Is it next week, I think?
No. Let me look. I'm gonna look real quick.
Alright, let's make sure your game's a crash. I'm going back to the traffic, and still, the battle for third is still kind of cold down right now. Ron Coles over Romar Arns over Jim Barrett.
Whoa, Ron was really high there. Romar, right up
Romar's
the
almost.
Not sure what happened there, he just maybe braked late or something. You can see the effects of over-braking here.
Yeah, talking about brakes at this track, is there any track that's worse on brakes than this place?
Not really.
Because, like, just trying to slow down from 120 to about 60 miles per hour, in these turns, it's like really hard.
And think about it, this is actual realistic speed, so in real life, NASCAR goes through here at 60 miles an hour. Think about it, that's how fast you go on the highway, and you're sitting down in a corner, bumper to bumper, so think about that. And then 120 miles an hour, that's double the speed you go on the highway, so that's in this very small track, you range from those type of speeds, big difference.
Do you think, Hampshire would be
Hampshire also, very hard.
Yeah,
good
New Hampshire.
Yeah. These two tracks are horrendous. I wonder which one's worse, because there's higher speeds in New Hampshire, but tighter racing here.
Well, they don't, I think as a ratio, they're about equal, because New Hampshire you get up to about 160, but you only go down to about 100, 110. Here it's 120 to 160, so.
I would say maybe it's actually rough around brakes in Hampshire.
It may be.
And there has been a lot of people there that have had many brake issues. I think maybe sometimes it's outnumbered than here, might you? Be a good question.
Yeah, true.
What do they wonder about that? Looking for the science. Oh, I was about to say, Luis really catching Marcio. He was down to about 1.6 seconds, and then I don't know what he did last lap, but he lost about 4 tenths, now he's about 2 seconds behind.
Yeah.
Still in there, but Marcio's really, really fast.
It seems like still the best battle on track is the Romar and Ron Coles.
Yeah, Romar and Ron.
Two R's. Jim's.
And then Jim
jumped off
watched.
Just a tad. Yeah, he's just waiting. It's like, maybe if they go up there and hit each other. Oh, did Ron just hit the inside of the wall?
I don't know. He got loose down on the inside. I wonder if he's going to give it here. He's going to give it away to Romar. Whoa, Romar.
Romar,
really
way
hard.
Wide. Yeah. To get underneath him.
He
was first and second. Roma had to break the straightaway.
And that allows Jim to close in the world. They're almost three wide in the middle of the corner.
Very good race.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Nice and clean. We should take a ride on board Roma right here. He's right beside him now. We're braking so important. We're trying to get the max positions they can, and looks like Roma
is clear.
Well, finally,
pass off the top three.
Finally passed.
After about how many laps of trying? Let's say about
well, all
30, 40. Well,
now he might
just
another one here to Jim.
Yeah, maybe that side damage that he has on his car is finally affecting him.
Maybe he didn't. Well, I'm not sure. I don't see any left side damage there. So.
Yeah,
but
yep,
he has fallen
like
back
he came
two
pretty
spots.
Close.
The Canadians, fourth and fifth. Where's the other one? Len Vent. He's back in ninth. Kicking in at that.
Yeah, talk about
Ron,
place.
Fall back. He's really off the pace now. Really slowing down.
Like, if talking about a place trying to finish, this is one of those ones where if you finish it, you did something.
Yeah, big time. You avoided all those hacks, you didn't overbrake, and the car cleaned hopefully.
But looking at Len Vent's car right now, I mean, it's back. Looks about normal.
Yeah, just a couple of dents here and there.
Yeah, a couple dents, but they got most of the damage knocked out. He's back going, a couple laps down. If you get a couple of late race wrecks, coming 20 to go, get back into things.
4 second lead now from Marcio. He is not slowing down. Wow.
It's looking like Marcio's gonna catch up with the back of the field shortly. He's only a couple seconds behind him.
Marcio's last lap at 20.280. Luis's 20.536. He's beating by about 3/10 a lap. That is huge. Whoa, Len Vent. That's Denver still hanging in there. Very far off. 3 laps, about 6 laps. Johnny Len. The last kind of lead lap. We're keeping it close right now to Eric Harlan. Did Eric Harlan get passed by Eller? He did, didn't he? Eller used up another spot. Ron continuing to fall behind. So I don't know what he did. Maybe he's tired. Maybe he made an adjustment on the last pit stop. But off the pace. Ron Cole. I'm also surprised here, I haven't raced the Martinsville race in a very long time, but I've noticed that they're not really using the bottom lane. They're sort of up in the middle, to the top of that hatch. So it's on edge.
Yeah, I've noticed that too, actually. Which, I mean, it seems like in the last couple of years, like, the lines of a couple of tracks have changed. In Bristol, now they run near the top, and here they, like, back in the early 2000s area, like, everybody, like, tried to, like...
Fight for the bottom.
Yeah, fight right for the bottom. Like, if you get off the bottom, you could go right to the back.
And now, also, if you're in the last time NASCAR was the market, Tony Stewart held off Jimmie Johnson. Haha, eBay. Held off Jimmie Johnson on the high side.
That's
that
true.
Race. So maybe a second line developing here, Martin.
Yeah. But looks like did Ellery Sullivan just pass Eric Harlan?
They're close though. So. I wondered about that too. It looked like passing Ellery, so I guess Eric just having some fun. For six.
Yeah. Might be trying to get it back here.
Oh, yeah,
close
they
to
drove
him.
It in hard, and look right behind them, Ronnie Martin. Good to see him start to close in.
And oh, Eric's
going
to move, going into He's gonna get it. Looks like. Yes.
That way he's gonna give it.
Here he goes. Getting clear.
Don't need to push it. Just accept the position.
Oh. Right, going into turn one.
Bronco still falling away. Way behind. Lap 82 of 125. So the race past halfway. Big time. So nearing the end here. Up in front of their caution and tighten these guys back up. Right now it's a 6 second lead, man. 6 seconds.
Wow.
That is just massive.
It's stretching it, it's stretching.
Quarter
it
of the track.
Yeah, Marcio's turn three while Luis comes off turn two.
Yeah.
So, entire straightaway.
So let's give you it. He just passed the line now. And here comes Luis. He's at the line now.
I'm noticing something. It seems Romar's starting to catch Luis.
Oh yeah, it is. Maybe it's not so much Marcio pulling away as it might be Luis falling off.
Maybe.
They're now late charge here by Romar. I wonder if they have to pit again. They're probably going to have to pit against the fuel.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they'll
fight. So I wonder if Jim usually does like to do some strategy. No tires, just fuel or something. But I look at how far he is back now. I'm not sure about that.
I don't know.
Never know. Maybe something might work.
At a place like Martinsville, I don't know if you want to go too long without tires.
Yeah, it's true. They were really badly here. Bronco's still falling way back. He's lost 7 seconds to his previous third place position. Eric Harlan and Ronnie Martin. Where did Ellery go? Oh, he's in the pits. Okay. First pit stop, I guess. He's in the pits. You know what I'm thinking? Maybe the two guys who didn't qualify, they pulled off a bit of a David Nadden move and didn't qualify to get the back of the pack pit stall. Like David here used to pull off all the time. But also, I'm thinking that might be important because they don't want to pit off the curve.
That's true, though. Yeah, Ellery's coming out of the pits. He's going to rejoin the track.
This is a four tire stop.
One off? Linvin.
Sorry about that. Sorry. We wish LeJuan was here.
If Juan was here, that'd be awesome. And Luis Almeida's going down pit road.
Luis? Oh, Luis is in the pits. He was
coming from
off the pace a lot.
Yeah, maybe he'll get a little change, wedge change or something like that. Maybe it'll help him out.
See what he does. He has the first pit stall. And lap 90, Jesus. Imagine racing in Martinsville with only one caution.
I've seen it before, it's only happened like one time. So.
Yeah.
Their fields here are increasingly smaller and smaller, so hopefully
they'll change.
Yeah, maybe.
Not just for all of
them. Certainly it seems like it's going to flip off. Now it's a truck series that's more popular. I don't know why.
Yeah.
And then the Cup and the main stripes are falling off. So I'm not sure if this change is imminent. So while Luis is done, I'm going to check in to see if anyone else hit road.
Yeah, feel kind of mixed up right now. If they had a caution, man, Ellery and Luis would be like, horrible for them.
But what's pretty cool about this broadcast right now is you're listening to three previous race car drivers in the race within VHR, so we can give you extensive, you know, things that, like info about how the drivers are feeling and what they're doing and how the track is and what they're dealing with. Right here. Yeah. How about that?
We have this at one here at Martinsville.
Yeah, we have one. Have you won two?
I have won one race.
Yeah?
Yeah, not with the race to play, but FBR Motorsports, the league migrated over from NASCAR racing in 2003. So I kind of had the advantage on them because I've been racing BHR for a while. So it was their first season, and I smoked them at Mars.
Marcio's trying to pass Ron Coles right now, and he had to lock him up going into turn one. They actually made a little contact.
Oh, they did? I'm seeing my camera here on that pit road, so I can see it.
Marcio's still trying to get around Ron. I think he's putting him a lot down. Yes, actually he is.
Oh, someone smoked him going in.
Eric Harlan, maybe? Yep. I think Ron's still trying to charge you plowing outside. He almost tagged the wall there.
Did he hit the wall?
Sure. Yeah.
You gotta be careful there, Ron.
Nope. He's gonna lose a spot to Ronnie.
Is that the position? Wow, he's falling very far back.
First car
what I think
down.
He's gonna be doing here is going on a very long tire run and maybe towards the end of the race. Kinda
stay out, gain some grip later on, but I'm not sure that's gonna really help him now. He's falling way back. And he came into pits very hot. Ron Coles is in pits, guys. I guess a big change in the minute here for his car. Let's hope he wasn't speeding.
And there's a wreck in turn four, Ronnie Martin.
What happened?
Oh, Marcio Caritano, the leader.
Marcio got spun by Ronnie Martin.
Oh, that's unusual, and it is a lot of year-end damage. Wow. So while Ron is in the pit, he's going to get a bit of a break here. Complete his pit stop.
Ronnie Martin don't look like he has much run damage, actually.
Get caught up there, buddy.
I don't know what happened there, really.
I'm going to look at the replay here and see what happens.
Yeah, Marshall's got some damage.
Heavy damage. There. So it looks like... Oh no, Marcio was already spinning.
Oh really?
Marcio spun, went into the corner, popped into the corner, and he slid up into Ronnie. Ronnie just smashed him right in the back. Wow. So Marcio just lost it. So after having that huge lead, now he has massive rear end damage. And trust me, that's going to affect the handling of your car.
Time.
Big time.
Yep. Let's see if
it's going to make him very loose. He's going to fall back here, and he's going to have a lot of time on damage, so not sure if that was a big break or not for Ron Coles.
And here's just the thing I've noticed. There's three people that are one lap down that got stuck a lap down after that.
And unfortunately, Ron Coles too high entering the pits. He had to pass through penalty. He's going to have to serve.
Romar Arndt is currently the leader, and he's going to enter his first with... Jim Bear suffering
behind him. And what did we tell you before, guys? Here is the man, Jim Bear off. Towards the end of the race, everything works in his hands. Most of the time, second place. One more arch. That's another arch. And pit stop have started. There's Luis. There is a battered car of Marcio. I thought
there might be a caution, but definitely not with Marcio. He was on a roll.
Yep, Romar coming, Arnes. And then Jim's falling right down, so...
Okay, Romar,
second right there.
Barisov, Almeida, Stenger,
Eric Harlan will be third, looks like.
Oh, no! Oh, almost contact there, came out of the pits.
Yeah, I think Eric did get third there.
Oh, did he? Wow.
Yeah, he ended up getting third, just barely.
Oh, whoa, another one entering the pits here, again.
He's not done. He wants to make sure he got all the damage fixed. Or
yeah.
And Ron Cole's currently in front of the field, but he is a lap down.
Many laps down, I believe. One lap down.
Somebody on Facebook wanted me to give him a shout out. His name's Russell Mazingo. Just saying hi.
Oh, is he watching?
Yes, he is. We actually have 7 viewers right now. For our first race, that's really good. So if any of y'all want
to
get into some of
this
action, just go to racetoplay.com, register for it, go sign up with DBF Motorsports or in the future with iPro Race Association.
Yes.
And just
do it!
Sign up for a race, and yeah, do it. It's there, free. Well, you can get a membership if you want to, so... You better get out of the races. Say what?
Yeah, it's cool, man.
And
drivers want to be. Oh, let's go back green.
Green flag, green flag.
Oh, we are green. Ah, all right. Romar leading Jim Lewis. I don't know. Hey. Lewis is a lap down. Lewis has only been on a few laps. He got trapped on a lap down.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a bummer. And there goes Runkle's.
Ooh, Jim Harrison trying to go low on him. Trying to get on Romar there, but Romar's keeping.
Battle for the lead, and Luis looking for the lucky dog. Hopefully a caution, but not much time left. Under 20 laps to go. So this is going to tighten things up, and two cars that have been really close all race long are right here together at the end. Romar Orange and Jim Harrison, two completely different ends of the bumper. Romar being a very fast, aggressive driver, and Aristov being very cool and relaxed, very conservative, and he's there. A little lap car in the way. Right pin down Romar.
Right now we have. After this lap right here, it's going to be 16 laps to go, so coming down close to the end. Is Romar going to be able to hold everybody off? Going to be a light race caution, maybe?
I can't stop thinking that there's actually 7 viewers right now, man. I feel so honored.
Yeah.
Hope eBay's still on the line. I'm sure he's still watching.
Yeah, I'd say he probably is.
Dawson Mazingo and all those other guys.
Eric Carlin,
I wonder who the other guys
are. Ellery.
The other guy should go on Facebook and message Haven real quick. Be like, hey, it's me.
I'm just saying what other people are thinking.
That's cool.
Hopefully everybody likes what I'm doing.
Likes my sexy commentator?
Oh, love it.
Yes. And don't forget, city comments are sexy commentators. Wow, can you believe Eric Carlin's in third right now and Ronnie Martin's in fourth? What a turnaround for these two. These guys weren't even in the top five before. Wow.
Seems
that
like
is cool.
Romar's starting to catch Ron. I think he had to get his black flag fixed, so.
Yeah.
So he's
looks
back
like
out there.
Looks like Marcia's back in fifth, man. Way back.
Wow.
There.
Yeah, I think his spin just killed his car.
Yeah, very extensive damage there. Oh, it's fine now, man. It's pretty much destroyed.
Internally, it's not good.
I can't believe Eric Carlin's a bird, man. He just pulled on like a Joseph Martin or like Tom Olsey out of nowhere. But this one would make the DBF for seconds there. Ready to kill him. Yeah. Ron back to 7 sucks. He's having a good race. But they're on. Whoa! Oh, he almost snagged the wall. Romar. 10 laps to go right now. That's a 10 lap to go mark.
I was going to say something before the end. Speaking of like really good fields and stuff. At Race to Play, like MNRL, Monday Night Racing League, they had a series that was, they ran Celine Mustangs. And, me and Blanco's league here, we're gonna be starting up a series here shortly. Gonna be doing the same series, the Celine Mustangs. We're gonna have them live broadcasted, so hopefully people come out and check that out. And hopefully we have some good racing.
We have some people watching the race tonight. Hopefully they can come out and race with us. Billion Mustangs, we're making a sweet, sweet schedule. Possibly two races every Thursday, Friday. We'll figure out a date.
Yeah, we'll figure out the date.
And we'll be back with you, so. Yeah.
Come race with us!
Oh, yeah. Looks like the leaders are catching the tail end of the field here.
Yes.
Just behind the wrong poles. And again, it's those three people, Ron Coles, Romar Arns, and Jim Barrison. Those guys have not been able to get rid of each other this race. They're always there. They're getting annoying.
Yep, it's looking like Romar's pulling away from Jim, so I'm unless he has a problem, it's looking like he might just sweep this one up.
You know, I just noticed, I remember Ronnie Martin was the one. I never saw damage on Ronnie's car, so what I'm thinking, maybe Marcio lagged, that's why he spun, he still lagged when Ronnie hit him. Maybe that's why Ronnie didn't get any damage, so a lucky break maybe there for Ronnie. Now, I'm not 100% sure that he didn't get any damage, but I'm just saying, after that, no damage spotted in front of him. Good loss for Jim Gow.
Looks like Jim had a technical difficulty, it seems like.
Yeah, I don't see him on the map at all. He's not even there. You see him when I pull on the car, he was out in the grass.
Yeah.
Grabbing him here.
He's lost connection.
With four laps.
That is horrible.
That's not.
I hate to see that.
That's horrible. A DNF, you race all this time and you don't finish. That is heart-wrenching.
Too good.
Yep, two laps to go here for Romar. Got a very clean race. Got a scratch on that car. Eric Harlan, would you believe, is in second place with a heartbreak.
Gosh, that is...
There we go. Omar Arns has won here at Martinsville.
Yes, good job.
Eric Harlan has gotten second. What a race for him, man. Out of nowhere. Wow, never saw him finish in second. Ronnie Martin has finished third. Marcio Cayetano finishes fourth. Last on the lead lap is Luis Almeida in fifth. Ron Poles finishes sixth and one lap down. Two laps down, Elie Zuza in seventh. Tim Barris up with a heartbreak in eighth. Now that he's in Len Fenn, the Canadian. He's still in it. Wow. Good finish for him. And Gustin, 10th.
Check for that burnout.
Yeah, check out that burnout, man. Romar. Good win. Pretty cool.
He hit the ball. He pulled off a great ball.
Yes, good win for Omar. Started in top five. Ran a good one all race, and yeah. A good race.
He's still burning out. Jeez.
Yeah, man, he's happy with this.
Hey, Omar, you can stop now.
Hey, let him have his fun. He's loving it.
It's Martinsville. He deserved it.
Yeah.
Is Jim still down in the TeamSpeak area?
No, he had himself a connection.
Yeah, he disconnected. That's why he left. We're going to think of interviewing. But
yeah, Blanco, you going to do some interviewing here in a second if we can?
Okay. See if we can grab Ron Coles or somebody.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Go match with someone. I'm David Pim. I do that kind of stuff. I just send him off to do stuff. He does it. Yeah. He'll come back up here and you have no idea what I'm talking about. Ah.
While we wait, I want to give a shout out to Jacob Lowry, who's probably watching this broadcast as well.
We have Ron Coles here.
Jacob. Now we have Ron Coles.
Hey, Ron.
How's everybody? How are you?
Pretty good. How was the race?
Welcome back, Jim. Not too bad, actually.
Yeah, we were watching, broadcasting the entire time. Looks like you had a lot of right side damage.
Yeah. I tagged the wall a couple of times, slowed me down a little bit, caused me to run off my tires.
That sucks.
How was the racing from down there?
Pretty
clean, really. For the most part, guys were doing very well. Not too many bumping and banging going on, so I thought everybody did a great job.
Cool. I was cheering you on, man. Cheering on my Canadians.
What's that?
I was cheering you on, man. Cheering on my Canadians.
Yeah, well, I tried. I was. trying to hang with the top two there for the first part of the race, and when I hit the wall the second time, that just did my my toe in, and it just tore that right front tire right off the car.
Sucks.
Couldn't get any grip coming out of the corner. I tried to hold Romar off as best I could.
But
he was
still
working hard behind me.
Yeah, speaking of Romar, it looks like he's here in the booth with us.
Congratulations.
On that clean run, and you timed it right to get up front and take that win.
Oh, yeah, Romar's here. All right, congratulations,
yes,
Romar.
Good.
Yeah. Thank you. That was a really good race, clean and fun. Thank you to all drivers.
Yep. Congratulations, dude. Very nice, man.
Yes, good
job.
Well
done, Romar.
Yeah, that was a tough break for Marcio. Wonder if we can get him up here in the booth and comment on that spin.
Oh,
that
yeah,
he did.
Marcio, yeah, the big spin he had. Mm-hmm.
Bear it back, guys.
He's not a pimp. I mean, I'm a pimp, yeah. How it works. Just send him off doing stuff.
I'd like to ask Romar a question.
All right, shoot.
Romar, were you working hard trying to get around me for the first part of the race?
Yeah, it was hard, but my setup was very, very stable, and the tires good too.
Yeah, mine was pretty stable until I hit that wall. That was it.
And that was a long race, Nick. So I'm not too fast, but I'm lucky.
Well, they say it's better to be lucky than good sometimes. Anyway, gentlemen, I'll let you go. I got to call it a night. Great having you guys aboard broadcasting this for DBF Motorsports and Race to Play. I'm sure
yep.
Tom would very much appreciate it. So thank you very much from DBF.
Thank you, Ron, anytime. Taking the time to join us.
Yep, thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for your time, Ron.
Have a good night, gentlemen. Later.
Their English ain't good, but then I said Romar did it, so.
Sorry?
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. I figured, I didn't know if Marcio was comfortable enough to come up into the booth.
Yeah.
All right, so a little message to the people watching. If you're still tuned in, if you want to comment or describe how your feeling was by watching the broadcast, you could, chime in on either one of our walls on Facebook or Race to Play or message us or leave a message on our group of Elite Racing Association on Facebook. You could tell us how we did, if you want us to do anything different next time and or do anything new or not do something, if we did something wrong or whatever. Tell us how we did, what you think, and post it on our Facebook, man. We love it. We love the input.
Yep.
All right, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out, and this concludes our broadcast for this evening.
See you next weekend, guys.
Yep, see you next.